Who is Astro Boy? Where did he come from? In the year 2000, there was no Astro Boy. There was a real boy named Astor Boynton. One day, he was racing his aero car at supersonic speed on the world's safest road, Electronic Highway 66. No need for Astor to steer, speed up, or slow down. The highway controlled his car automatically. All Astor had to do was press a button. The road did the rest. Yes, this was the highway of the future, safe as man could make it. No need to worry about a thing, or was there? But it was too late.
Oh! 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 My son! My poor boy.
That night, at the Institute of Science, headed by Astor's father.
My son, do you think I'll never see you again?
If only I could think of a way to bring Astor back to life. I know it's impossible, but if I were to construct a robot. That's it, robot. I'll build a robot that looks like Astor. It'll be my masterpiece. He'll live forever. Forever. From now on, fellow scientists, every test tube and every machine we have is going to be devoted to one purpose, the construction of a super robot. That clear? The robot will look just like my son, Astor. He'll operate on a rocket motor generating more than 100,000 horsepower. He'll leap over mountains, swim oceans, conquer space.
I believe that Jackie Boynton's going mad.
Hey!
I said I believe that Jackie Boynton's going mad!
We will begin this new project at once. I know that I can count upon you all to help me. The robot must be finished no later than 1 year from today. From now on, this is my life's work.
And so, the very next day, every man and every machine in the great Institute of Science turned to a single task, the creation of Dr. Boynton's super robot. The months flew by.
Exactly 1 year since I lost my son, but now I gained another. My new son is going to be a credit to the original Astor Boynton. I hereby christen thee my robot son, Astro Boy.
Thank you.
Astro Boy. My boy, do you understand who I am? I'm your father. And you're my son.
From this day on, you live with me in my house. Understand?
Yes, sir.
Call me father.
Father.
And I'm going to be a good father to you too, my son. I'm going to teach you everything that there is to know. I'll teach you how to fly, how to swim oceans, how to leap over mountains, how to be the bravest boy in the whole world. I'll be proud of you, son.
Listen, Astro Boy. Think hard. What's the answer?
6 billion 20.
Right. No, just draw what you see, huh? Why, it's drawing the molecular structure.
And so the years passed. And passed. And passed. Astro Boy's mind absorbed every lesson it was taught. The boy was happy, beloved by all, the apple of his father's eye, until one day Dr. Boynton noticed that Astro Boy had failed to grow like all the other children. He just remained the same size. And Dr. Boynton began to wonder if somehow he hadn't made a mistake.
I tell you, son, that I am unable to understand how, after years of developing into a mental giant, you have failed to grow as much as a single solitary inch. I've been a good father to you, haven't I? Well then, why can't you be a good son to me and grow up to be a normal human child like all the other children around here your same age?
Oh, the shame of it, the terrible shame! Please, my boy, for my sake, try to grow a little, won't you? See if you can grow just a few inches.
Yikes! No, no, it is not like that! No, I'm sorry, you were created!
Oh, Father, how can you say that? You've always told me that you love me as though I were your very own flesh and blood.
Flesh and blood? Why, that's a joke, son. A hideous joke!
Father, don't say that. After all, I'm your son. I'm your very own Astro Boy. Father! Father, Father, come back!
Let me go! Let me go! Yay! If you don't leave by yourself, I'm going to put you out! Do you understand? Those are my ownership papers for the robot. Mm. He's for sale.
And you say he can be used for any purpose that strikes my fancy? Very well, my friend. You got yourself a deal.
Good. I'll transfer papers at once. Astro, come here! Astro, I've just sold you. From now on, you belong to him.
Huh? Oh, no, Father, you can't.
Too late. The deal's been made. You're to pack your things at once and get ready to leave.
You stole me. You stole me. I can't believe it.
What's not to believe? After all, you're not a human child. You're nothing but a machine, like a refrigerator or a dishwasher. Remember, you're a robot. Somehow.
You're nice, huh? Oh, sure.
Your attention, please, ladies and gentlemen.
Gatchitori the Great, that's me, is pleased to present my big act. The great masterpiece of electronic art created especially for me by the world-famous Institute of Science. Presenting Astro Boy. This mighty robot boy, powered by a motor with 100,000 horses, will now attempt to fight the mighty robot Zag in a great fight in which one will be destroyed. At once. This is a cruel, cruel thing you're doing, and right in the public eye, it's a disgrace. Remember, robots are living things too. Why, it's just like ancient Rome with gladiators. Where gladiators were supposed to fight to the bitter end, and the one who lost was, I'm awfully sorry, but you see, every time I get mad, I sneeze. And this gets me mad.
Oh, you're getting mad, huh? Well, what about me, the great Cacciatore? How do you think I feel about your breaking up my show? I'm running a high-class circus with the greatest robots on Earth, and you got the nerve to come down here and tell me my show's no good? Look at these. Licenses for every act in the circus. You see, any place in the license where it says the robots cannot fight each other, huh? No. Cacciatore Circus is 102% legal. Even the crowd is against you.
All right. It's just that this poor little boy seems to be so utterly defenseless.
What you say? Take a good look and you're going to see that this young robot is a picture of hell. We should all be so strong. Fight to the finish and you don't finish.
I couldn't bring myself to do it. I don't want to harm anybody, not even Zog.
Oh. A smart robot, huh? What do you think you're going to do next time I put you two out in the middle ring together? Huh?
Same thing, I suppose.
You do, and I'll... Oh! My hand! All right, smart robot. From now on, no more electricity for you.
Mr. Cacciatore, allow me to introduce myself. I am Pachydermis J. Elephant, new head of the Institute of Science. I'm replacing Dr. Boynton, who was persuaded to resign because of his health. His physician felt that Dr. Boynton needed a rest.
So, what do you want from me?
I order you to return Astro Boy to the Institute of Science.
Meanwhile, Astro Boy sadly walked from tent to tent.
What on earth's the matter? Mechanically stuffed? No, just out of power. I'm being sold to a scrap dealer. It's true. Cacciatore's going to sell me.
Oh, no, he can't be that cruel.
No, I ran out of juice more than 2 weeks ago. Since then, I haven't been plugged in once. Not once.
But why would he want to sell you? What have you done?
He doesn't please the crowd any longer. That's why. Round here, if you lose your popularity, you're a goner. Look at me. One time I was captain of the Tin Brigade.
If Cacciatore would feed me, I'd be all right. But it's too late for that now.
Wait, I have an idea. We can share my power.
12 volts, that's enough for us all. I'll just connect my power cord to your socket and... Oh, where is it?
On my hip, but I feel a trifle silly. Oh, I'm ticklish.
Can I have a shot, too?
Have you enough for me?
Sure.
It's absolutely out of the question. Astro Boy's the property of the great Cacciatore. The sale was final and he cannot be returned for any price.
Your money will be jeopardy refunded. You see, Astro Boy is a masterpiece of science, the greatest robot ever created. And as such, he must be returned to the Institute.
Returned to the Institute? Listen, you, I paid lots of money for that lousy robot and he ain't going no place. He's staying with Cacciatore.
You say you won't turn him over?
You can try to take him away if you like, but that would make you guilty of petty thievery, and I would have to turn you over to the police.
What?
Please, Mr. Elephant, you hold that cane tight, huh?
Outrage. Rest assured, Signor Cacciatore, that you'll not get away with this. I shall see to it that not only Astro Boy is released, but the others too.
One sake, Gesundheit.
The robot cannonball will attempt to leap through an electric arc of more than 1 million volts. Absolute silence, please.
Everybody, and Katori's missing. Huh? You're right.
trapped that I can't get out. Help me out of here, Astro Boy. I've always been good to you. Help me, please.
Just like I told you before, I'm Astro Boy's master. It's natural to help me.
What an ungrateful person you are. Why, Astro Boy saved your very life.
All right. What am I supposed to say? Thank you to a robot? He owes me a lot after all I did for him. I took him into my circus, made him a star, built him in front of the whole public, and now he's about time the kid did something to repay my kindness.
Stop beneath the dignity of being called a human being.
Now, if you want to take Astro Boy from me, go get a lawyer. Drag me into court. Sue me. Go ahead. I have to win because I have the right legal papers, Elephant Puss.
Listen, Cacciatore, a lot of things have been happening while you were in the hospital. If you don't believe me, listen to this newsflash.
And so, ladies and gentlemen, 100,000 robots assembled in the great plaza below have just heard the joyous news that they are free. The Robot Bill of Rights, signed this morning, now prohibits the purchase...
It's a trick by the Institute of Science.
No, not trick by the Institute of Science. This is a decision that was reached by all mankind.
I'm not giving Astro Boy back. I bought him for a lot of money.
If you don't release the boy, you'll be guilty of a crime not against me, but against humanity. You see, he belongs to all mankind. Coming, Astro Boy?